I am definitely straight. Definitely straight. I mean,
Don't go ahead. You got something to add?
I'm sure we've all had our little experiences. It's a little dibble dabble, maybe too many drinks or whatever. Oh, girl, come look at me. But definitely straight.
So you're straight, but you have kissed a girl?
Yeah, I have.
Okay.
It was just like, whatever. We were just like, oh, let's try it out. And we just did it.
Just a friend of yours?
Yeah, well, we don't talk anymore.
Okay.
So that kind of makes it look bad. But yeah, it's nothing serious. Like, it was nothing serious. Like, I was not turned on or anything like that. So I knew that wasn't for me.
Now, was it a one-time thing? Or do you think it's something that might happen again in the future?
Oh, no, it's not going to happen again. I have to be, like, really drunk. But I don't even drink like that for it to even happen again. So I don't think so. No.
All right. What about you? Straight? Gay, bisexual, or
non-sexual? That is really tough. I'm straight, but just like she said, I mean, I kissed the girl. I liked it. It was fun. Nothing serious, though. Like, I wouldn't date a girl, but yeah.
Okay, now so far, this question right here is for both of you. Can you really say that you're straight if you kissed a girl and liked it?
Yeah, if you won't date a girl, it's just more like...
I mean, I'm thinking of it from a male perspective. Like, let's say I kissed a guy. Let's say I say, you know what, I'm straight, y'all, but one time... Me and Henry, you know.
But that's weird. That's like when guys be like, oh, it's a turn on to see two girls kiss. But I don't want to see two guys kiss. That's not cute.
But then again, why would you classify as bisexual if you wouldn't date a girl?
Because sexual preference is just who you're attracted to, not who you date. Like, a person could have never dated anybody or had sex with anybody, but you could still be straight or gay.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, that's,
Now, what about you?
I'm straight.
You're straight? Mm-hmm. You're straight or are you straight?
No, I'm really straight.
Never kissed a girl.
Okay.
She's on our boat.
Maybe one time I had a little bit too much to drink in Panama, and it was just like a, like,
so I know there's a pattern here. You're sort of blaming on, like, alcohol or other circumstances.
Because you'd be like, it'd be...
But you still consider yourself straight?
Yes, definitely.
Even though you kissed the girl and liked it?
No, I didn't like it.
Yeah. You didn't like it?
It wasn't anything that I was like, oh my gosh, I love that. No, it was like...
Oh. What made you want to try it in the first place?
Just because. I got dared to. So, yeah.
Okay.
That's it.
What about you?
I'm bisexual.
Finally, we got an honest answer. Yes,
I have a girlfriend currently, and we dated for 2 years, and then we broke up, and now we're back together.
Okay, so you're not a lesbian, but you're bisexual. So you would date guys too?
Yeah, I had a boyfriend after I dated her.
And what do you prefer?
I prefer guys over girls.
And when it comes to dating or sexual or both?
Both, because girls are too. They're crazy.
Yeah.
They are too emotionally attached, and they argue about everything.
Okay. All right. Okay, so I'm assuming you always say that you like guys better than girls, too. Mm-hmm. Now, what kind of guys are you into? Just in a general sense. I mean, I know it depends, but, you know, just
like,
in a general sense.
Tall, dark, handsome, nice hair, money.
I knew that was coming. Okay.
Just have to be well put together, headed down.
Now, what does that mean?
Like, I don't want, like, a hood guy. So.
Oh, no, we don't want.
So, like,
I don't want a thug.
No, not at all. That's disgusting.
A lot of guys are into thugs.
Okay, no. Not me. But yeah, someone that definitely knows
college.
How to present themselves.
Yeah. I don't think college students are into thugs.
Mm-hmm. You'd be surprised. What kind of guys are you into?
Well, I like a nice, tall. I don't think complexion matters, but yeah, complexion
does
doesn't
matter.
Does race matter? Race doesn't matter, I think. The other races are a little intimidated, I think, but they do like us though. But
so
I
what
think
are you saying? You think, like, if a white guy saw you walking down the street, for example,
he wouldn't approach me. The only way I think they'll approach us black girls is probably like via like social media, like Tinder and Instagram. But besides that, that's where the two white guys I did talk to approached me on Instagram and Tinder.
So what message would you have to a white guy watching this?
We like y'all too. Don't be scared.
All right, what about you? What kind of guy do you like?
I don't like your typical African-American dude. I don't like them hood. I like
I like when you have a position or power, when you're doing something in your life, like that's a turn on. Like, oh my gosh, he's president of this, or oh my gosh, he just graduated with like a bachelor's.
So it's sort of what she said, you basically want a guy with money.
No, he doesn't have to have money. Like if people know me, I tell people like, I like don't want to be a widow, so I don't want you to be like a police officer, a fireman. I don't even want you to be a CEO, because then you know you have some corruption with money. I want you to be like a mailman. Something,
oh, no.
Something like, money is not, I don't care. As long as you're doing something with your life. Like, on top of that, like guys who are different, unique, like introduce me to stuff. Like I've dated guys who've introduced me into dubstep, like Tyler the Creator. Oh, you longboard, that's cool, teach me. Like, you have to be different. I don't like average Joe.
Can it be different and fit that personality type and be broke?
Definitely.
Can.
Yeah, you could be different. Yeah, I've seen it. Passed.
And it sounds like you wouldn't date a broke guy.
I mean, I have, and I've learned from my experience that it's not a good idea, because I was the provider and I did everything, and I've never had anything done for me in that relationship, and it was horrible. And once I left out of that relationship, I realized that wasn't what I wanted. So, yeah.
Okay, but just because you're dating a guy with money, does that mean that
he doesn't really have money. It's just that we both work hard for like what we have. Like basically, I just don't want a lazy guy, so I'm not really saying someone has to be like rich or have money. I just want someone that's able to work hard
and take care of themselves.
Take care of themselves and not be
happy.
No, I take care of myself. I have two jobs. I don't need them, but I don't want to have to provide for you. Like, oh, I need gas money. Do you have $50?
Yeah, I don't like a give
me. No, I don't like that.
Give me this. I want that. Type of man. Like, I'm really old school. Like, everybody mm-hmm. tells me that. Like, I like a guy that opens doors, throws away the trash, mm-hmm. like all that old school
but
stuff.
But are you doing things for him too?
Of course. I feel like a relationship should be 60-40. I'm just playing 50-50. I'm just playing 50-50. But then again, a man, if you want that man role, you want to be the man, then you're going to have to play a man role. Like, you're, of course you're gonna put out more than a female put out. Well, that's how I
am. I don't think that's true.
I think so. I think the man is gonna look as if he puts out more, mm-hmm. but then again, you want to come home to cook meal, you want to come home true. To wash clothes. So then again, the guy is probably spending more money, but the girl is probably mm-hmm. more of the household, the caretaker.
I think that's a pretty sexist way of looking at it though.
That you think that's sexist?
I think it should be equal. It should be 50.
Yeah. Yeah, I feel like
it should be 50-50, like,
but it's never like that.
I know what me and my boyfriend.
Girls like you, I mean, not no offense, but as long as girls keep thinking like you, it won't be like that, right?
It's not think like me. I just feel like certain stuff that guys are supposed to do.
It's pretty sexist. What do you think?
I mean, I'm like Southern, so I believe in certain things. Like I should, not should clean, but every day I cook dinner, like I clean the house, like I make sure the laundry's like clean for me and my boyfriend. So like, and then he does his own things exactly. too, so it's like.
So it's still equal to about 50-50.
Yeah.
Okay, all right, we're almost done here. Just have a, I'm gonna start with you. And I want you to be honest on this question. A lot of girls are not honest on this question.
Okay.
When you meet a guy or a girl, in general, how long would it take for you and them to get sexual? And be honest, I know your friends are sitting here, but.
To what, have sex?
Yeah.
Oh,
this is gonna sound bad. I
say,
no, I'm gonna be honest. Okay, well, I've only really ever dated two guys, so I would have to say, for one, it was about 2 years, and the one here, it would be about a year. I'm like year months type of person.
Because
you have to make sure, like, you don't just open your cookie and give everybody your cookie, because then when you give some, that's an intimate moment. Like when you have sex with someone and then like say it doesn't last, then you're like, oh my gosh, like I thought he liked
that
me.
Big of a deal anymore,
like,
though.
I mean, yeah, I'm sure everyone has had like those one night stands or whatever. But I don't even count those or whatever.
So
like,
you have had those too.
Oh, is this? I don't know if I want to admit to that.
That's already admitting to it.
Can we? Oh no, can we rebut? No. Okay. next. Who's next?
See, I said be honest.
What was
but
the
okay.
question?
Okay. The question is, in general, I know it depends, but in general, how long does it take for you to get sexual with a male or a female, even though you say with a female?
Honestly, I think it depends on where you're trying to go with the relationship. So if you meet a guy with the intentions of being with the guy, then I feel like probably, also I think it depends on your age too. College students don't really.
I'm talking about you personally.
Me, okay. How long does it take? I'll say like 2 months.
Is that an honest answer?
Yeah, for sure. 2 months.
It's never taken longer than that?
haven't took it. Of course. I mean, there's a year.
So depending on the guy.
It depends on the guy. Like, sometimes, like, the sexual attraction is there. And you guys are just,
so it could be shorter or longer than 2 months.
Yeah, depend on.
Could be, like, 2 weeks, 2 days, maybe. Depending on the guy.
Depending on the guy.
All right. And what about you, in general?
What's the question?
Like, when you meet a guy or a girl, how long does it take for you and them to get sexual? And be honest.
To get sexual? Oh, like 5 months.
5 months, why so long?
Because I just don't believe in giving myself to anyone. And, like, I just don't believe in it. And I just, it's like, I just feel like everybody starts off good, and then it's like, you know, I don't know. I feel like everybody starts off good, that little puppy love, the first stage of their relationship, and then, like, as you go on, months and months, then you realize, like, okay, this person isn't for me, or this person is. And it's like, if you had, like, say if I had an experience with this one person, I'm like, oh, okay, that didn't work out, and then that next relationship, I know, like, this is what's gonna happen. So, I don't know. So 5 months is, like, my safety net.
And what are you looking for in those 5 months? What has to happen in order for you to have sex?
It's just the connection, like, me being able to trust them, like, proving themselves that they're, like, they're just, how can I say
they're
this?
They're worthy.
Yeah, they're basically
worthy. Okay, that's an interesting word.
You're so close!
Yeah!
What about you? Well, the reason I'm so close is just so I can get your voice good.
Okay. I want to say like 2 months.
I don't want to hear what I want to say. I want to hear the honest truth.
I haven't had that many sexual partners, to be honest. So I'm trying to think about my last relationship. I want to say it was like 2 months.
Was this with a female?
No, it was with a male.
Does it matter, like, is it quicker or shorter or longer with a female than a male, or does it matter?
It doesn't matter. It depends on how we connect. So if, like, I feel like we're good and we're close and we have that connection, then it's whatever. I feel like with the female, I don't feel like it would take, I mean, 2 months isn't a long time, but I feel like females are more understanding and I feel like we have the same intentions at the end of the day, as far as like what we want to do.
So it would probably be quicker with a girl.
Probably. Than it would be with a boy.
All right. Anybody got any last words, advice, or anything regarding anything we talked about? Any last words, messages, advice regarding anything?
Don't be in relationships.
Don't get in relationships?
No, they're horrible.
I mean, in college, I mean, it takes time. Like, everybody's out here looking for something different. And these guys are just, they don't want what you want, what us females want sometimes. So, you know.
And everyone doesn't have the same motive in a relationship. Yeah. Some people get in a relationship to, like, use you. And some people are actually in it to build a, like, strong bond and connection and, like, build their future with you. And some people aren't. So.
Any last words from you?
No.
All right.